Today in this video we are going to see about the performance of contract under Indian Contract Act 1872, and particularly in this we are going to see the section 37 to section 50. We will see different topics, three subtopics: how contract must be performed, contract we know pretty well, then an agreement which is between two parties which is enforceable by law is contract. There should be an offer and there should be a proposal and it should be completed, then the contract is having the effect. So a promisor should be there and promisee should be there, and the promisor must perform the contract for a consideration from the promisee, and when both parties oblige, then the contract ends. In the contract என்பது எவ்வாறு நிறைவேற்றம் செய்யப்படுகிறது என்பதை நாம் பார்க்கின்றோம். செக்ஷன் 37 இருந்து 50 வரை இது மூன்று பிரிவுகளாக பார்க்கின்றோம். ஒன்று, contract which must be performed, contract என்பது செய்தாக வேண்டும், யாரால் செய்யப்பட வேண்டும். இரண்டாவது தலைப்பு. மூன்றாவது தலைப்பு, டைம் அண்ட் பிளேஸ் ஆஃப் பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ் ஆஃப் கான்ட்ராக்ட் என்ற மூன்று தலைப்பின் கீழ் பார்க்க இருக்கின்றோம். முதலிலே கான்ட்ராக்ட் விச் மஸ்ட் பி பெர்ஃபார்ம்டு என்றது செக்ஷன் 37, 38, 39 என்ற மூன்று செக்ஷனிலும், மற்ற பை ஹூம் கான்ட்ராக்ட் மஸ்ட் பி பெர்ஃபார்ம்டு அது ஒரு ஐந்து செக்ஷன். அடுத்ததாக டைம் அண்ட் பிளேஸ் ஆஃப் பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ் ஆஃப் கான்ட்ராக்ட் ஒரு ஐந்து செக்ஷன், ஆக 13 செக்ஷனில் பார்க்க இருக்கின்றோம். நவ் வி வில் சி தி அண்ட் பிஃபோர் தட் ஆஸ் அன் இன்ட்ரோடக்டரி பார்ட், ப்ராமிஸ் மஸ்ட் பி பெர்ஃபார்ம்டு பை ஹூம்? ஒன், பை த ப்ராமிசர் இட் செல்ஃப், ஆர் பை ஹிஸ் ஏஜென்ட், ஆர் பை ஹிஸ் லீகல் ரெப்ரசன்டேட்டிவ், ஆர் பை தேர்ட் பர்சன், ஆர் ஃப்ரம் ஜாயிண்ட் ப்ராமிசர். ஸோ பை தீஸ் பீப்புள் த ப்ராமிஸ் மஸ்ட் பி பெர்ஃபார்ம்டு. அண்ட் ரிகார்டிங் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ், தேர் ஆர் டூ டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ். ஒன் இஸ் கால்ட் ஆக்டிவ் பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ், தட் இஸ் த பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ் இஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்டட். இஃப் போத் பார்ட்டிஸ் டூ ஆக்ட் அக்கார்டிங் டு தி டேர்ம்ஸ் அண்ட் கண்டிஷன்ஸ் என்டர்ட் அப்பான் பை தெம், then the contract ends. That is called active performance. The other type of contract is tender, which is on the way of finishing the contract. Suppose if the contract stipulates that the tender will be given effect after 5 days, then it will be processed and it will be executed. And moreover, as per the terms and condition, the tender must be performed for as a type of contract. Then now we will see the section wise. First subtopic, contract which must be performed. The under the topic, the promise must be, promisor must perform. So the promisor, one who promise to do an act for the other, that promisor has to perform. That is section 37, obligation of parties to contract. So obligation means compulsorily they have to do. Obligation, the very word we use in a way whether it can be done or not, but it's not so. Obligation means compulsorily one must perform. Suppose if we go to an office, we ask the officer to do an obligation, but we think he can do or not, but it's not so. He should compulsorily do. Like that, here the obligation of parties to contract, both must perform, the promisor and promisee. For example, the A promises to deliver the goods to B on certain payment, and on the payment, when the payment is completed, the goods also delivered, then the contract is ended or performed. And suppose if A promises to do a drawing for by B, A promises to do a drawing for B, and then in the melee or in the course of drawing, if the death occurs, then the contract need not be completed, because he alone has to perform the drawing. So these are the illustration for the section 37. And section 38, effects of refusal to accept offer of performance. If it is refused by the promisee, then the promisor is not responsible. That is effect of refusal to accept offer of performance. So the promisor can go for the contract terms. As per the contract terms, some compensation or anything may be asked from the promisee. That is effect of refusal to accept offer of performance. Then section 39, effect of refusal of party to perform promise only. When suppose if the promise is not done completely as agreed upon, then he alone responsible, or his legal representatives are responsible. For example, a singer entered into a contract to perform singing twice a week on a particular day. Like that, it has to be completed for 6 weeks or so, but it is interrupted after a completion of 1 week, then the singer is wholly responsible for not performing his duty or his contract terms. That is effect of refusal of party to perform the promise wholly. Wholly means that is as agreed upon, a part has been completed but not fully. Then by whom contract must be performed? Section 41 to 45. Section 40, person by whom promise is to be performed. The promisor or his representatives are responsible. So actually, A enters into a contract with B. Suppose if B is not doing, or if B dies, his legal representatives have to do that work. That is the person by whom promise is to be performed. Then section 41, effect or accepting a performance from third person. Suppose if third person can also be enter into a contract, provided if the both promisor and promise accepts. And the problem is, once third party is accepted by the promisee, then the promisor cannot be held responsible. The promisee cannot take hold of the promisor for not doing the contract, because he already accepted the third party. And then section 42, devolution of joint liabilities. When the liability is jointly accepted by the promisee, then the liability will be divided among all the persons. Then section 43, anyone of joint promisors may be compelled to perform. Each promisor may compel contribution, sharing of loss by devolution of contribution. Actually, by promisee, any joint promisors may be compelled to perform. Suppose if the promisors are more, and if one party is not performing, the other parties may be compelled to perform the promise. That is the joint promisors, in the case of joint promisors. And the loss also, sharing of loss by default in contribution. By this is by suppose if the loss is also there, then it has to be contributed by the joint promisors. Then effect of release of one joint promisor. Suppose the joint promisors will be there, and if the promisee releases one person, one joint promisor, from the contract, that doesn't mean that the others are also released from that. The others are held responsible for even for the least promisor. Then the devolution of rights. The rights are among all it is divided. That is devolution of joint rights. That is section 45. Now we will see time and place of performance. Actually, the contract to be executed by the promisor as per the promises mentioned place and mentioned time. Then if it is not obliged, then the contract will not have effect. Now we will see the section 46. Time for performance of promise where no obligation to be made and no time is specified. So the no obligation is made means the obligation, the proper place is not proper time is not meant, mentioned. So time for performance of promise, no obligation is the time is not specified, but the thing is at specified time it should be completed, and that specified time is to be decided by law. Then time and place for performance of promise where time is specified and no obligation to be made. So time is specified but no place is maintained mentioned in the contract. That is time and place for performance of promise where time is specified and no obligation to be made. That means this place is not mentioned, but the place is as per the contract, though it is not separately mentioned. Section 49, place for performance of promise where no obligation to be made and no place fixed for performance. So here the place for performance of promise where no obligation to be made and no place fixed. So here also the place is not fixed, but it has to be ascertained from the contract the place of performance as per the even though no specific place is mentioned. And section 50, performance in manner or at time prescribed or sanctioned by promisee. Suppose if the promisee wants the goods to be placed at a certain warehouse at a certain time, that is say office time. Suppose if the goods are not delivered in the warehouse, specified warehouse, at a specified time, that is during office hours, and then the contract is not valid, that is not having effect, the performance is not completed. If the goods are delivered in the correct place but at beyond office hours, then the performance is not completed. That is section 50. So we will see in Tamil, contract niravetrai, oppandham niravetrai sambandhamana in the video section 37 irundhu section 50 varai adakkam idhil moondru subtopic galaga nam padikka irukkindrom. One, contract must be performed. By whom contract? Yaaral seiyapada vendum? Moondravathu, idam kaalam. Idamum kaalam இடமும் காலமும் கான்ட்ராக்டில் மென்ஷன் செய்திருக்கிறவாறு நாம் அதனை ப்ராமிசர் செய்ய வேண்டும் என்ற விதி. ஸோ இந்த மூன்று தலைப்பின் கீழ் நாம் இதனை வேர்த்திருக்கின்றோம். வித் திஸ் வி கம்ப்ளீட் திஸ் வீடியோ.